little walk this morning. And I guess what I wanted to talk about first is I've had a few questions concerning or asking me about my recent dental experience in the Philippines. And I had a lot of work done. And the story behind that is, back when I was a young 19-year-old sailor, I came to Guam and wound up in a dental chair on the Navy base, and a young Navy dentist, probably fresh out of dental school.
You sure you know he knows what he's doing?
Dr. Kiefer just graduated from dental school.
He drilled into one of my nerves, and I swear they had to scrape me off the ceiling. And it's something I've never forgotten, and I've got this deep embedded phobia because of that. So anytime a dentist fires up a drill on me, I'm just on edge.
Boy, this is gonna hurt.
Doctor, if it's gonna hurt, please give me something to kill the pain.
So anyway, I have a tendency to put off dental work. That's neither here nor there. The reason I went to the Philippines for all this dental work was about a little over a year ago, went to a dentist here in Guam. I had a cavity that I thought maybe needed attention. So he gave me a filling, charged me an exorbitant price. And so I proceeded to ask him about giving me an estimate on all my work. And just the work that we had addressed that day came in about $8,000. So naturally I said, there's no way. I don't have dental insurance. There's no way I can do this. I just wait till I get to the Philippines. And when the Philippines opened up, I started going to the dentist. And this last trip in August, I had started down a path of getting a lot of stuff repaired. And I had to make another trip to get it all done. And bottom line here is, all the work that I had done in the Philippines cost me just under $2,400. That same work in Guam would have cost me almost $15,000. Even if I had insurance, I figured out my copays would have been over $9,000, just my copay. So I saved a ton of money. I saved enough money to pay for round trip tickets to Guam and the Philippines back for the next couple of years. I thought the water used to be white. So really, the amount of money I saved was phenomenal. It leaves me a lot of money for beer and whatever. Maybe a trip to Japan or China or somewhere else. But anyway, I'm here at Ipao Beach Park in Guam. Taking my morning walk. Not too many people here. It's still early. Well, probably most people have come and gone already, but I was sitting in the bar across the street yesterday, me and Terry having a beer. Right there, she challenged me to a game of shuffleboard, and I challenged her to a beer drinking contest. Of course, I always win the beer drinking contest. She's like done at one, so I drank two and I beat her. Anyway. Heading to GMH. We're walking through the park, up and around the road, and back down the same way I just came in. And they're just making this big loop over and over and over. So I thought, I'll go measure that. So I've got my Strava running. We'll see how far it is. Maybe I can get a couple miles in today. Anyway, that's my dental story. So I had all this work done. And it got me a better smile than I had previously. Well, I'm happy. I still have some more work to do. some minor stuff, but I wrote a blog article about it and put it on my Patreon channel. And for those who may not know, you can join our Patreon channel for free.
You're kidding me!
Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me?
Before it was a members only thing, but now our followers can join for free and have access to public blog articles that I post there from time to time. If you want to upgrade your subscription, or I mean every little bit helps, keeps this channel going, and we appreciate you. So check out the blog post I wrote on dental, where I describe some of the cost differences between the United States and Philippines. It'll amaze you. I'm not sure if I mentioned this once before in one of my walks, but the federal government decided to outlaw cockfighting on the island of Guam. And it was a couple years ago, I guess. Since that time, I guess a lot of guys just let the roosters go. And there's chickens all over Guam now. I mean, everywhere. There's a proud cock and a whole brood of hens. You're a lucky dude. Anyway, I bet there's some eggs around here somewhere. If you had the energy and the courage to dig through the jungle, you could find a bunch of eggs. But yeah, there's roosters everywhere. Chickens and roosters, they're everywhere. I walked by this twice already and didn't see it, but I missed the one last year, November. I think we'll be here. We'll check it out. There's a sinkhole I didn't even know existed. It's a small one. I know there's another one up there on the hill, and there's one big one across the street. But I guess this is Sinkhole City. Eh, maybe I've mentioned before. I know I've done some videos before, but Terry and I have walked this entire beach from the Hilton all the way around to the Westin. It's right about there. I think it's 2.7 miles round trip. And it's a nice walk. But the problem is the beach slope. I'm not real keen for walking on a non-level ground, I guess you'd say. By the time I get all the way down there to the Westin, my right hip or my left hip's hurting. I can't remember which, but then I got to turn around and walk all the way back, and the other hip starts hurting. It's just walking on sideways on an incline. Not good for my lower back or my hips. But I do it anyway. Back in the barangay where we live, in Calbayog City, the only place for me to really walk is, we can walk on our beach at low tide when all the sand is exposed. Walk quite a ways out and quite a ways back. Do that enough times round trip, you get your kilometers in, I guess you'd say, over there. Here in Guam, there's no shortage of places to walk. But now in Calbayog, check out this new place, the new place to walk. The new coastal bypass. It's been under construction for a couple years now. I visited there just a short while ago, found out that it's becoming a popular place to walk. I don't know what's going on here on the bypass. Everybody seems to be hanging out.
Hey, yo.
Hey. and walking. I'm gonna measure this and see how far this walk is gonna be. I'm guessing probably a couple kilometers. Didn't have to walk too far before I ran out of people. I bet the farther I go, the fewer there are. Some people are into walking though. I hear this is fairly busy in the mornings. I'm gonna have to come out here some morning and check it out. Another half a mile yet, and I'm almost at the end. It'll be close to a mile when I'm done. I really thought it went farther than this, but it doesn't. That's okay, I can do it twice. Right now, it's just one big expensive walking track on Lover's Lane. Nice place to catch sunset.
Hi!
See that mountain off in the distance? I live at the base of that mountain, right on the ocean. I've done several videos climbing that mountain, so if you have the time, check it out. Yeah, it's just right at 1 mile. I'm back where I started. They got vendors set up here. This is the place to hang out. See what happens when they get the road actually opened. Take a little detour, see how the beach looks. That was tough. These are my kinds of beaches. I remember once me and Terry went to, we drove from North Mississippi all the way to Destin, Florida, just to go to the beach. Rented a condo across the street from the beach, 200 yards of sand to the beach, and you could not walk in that sand barefoot to the beach without burning your feet. And there was no shade, none. It was like full sun from the road to the beach. And we camped out there with a couple umbrellas for maybe an hour, two at the most, but it just got so darn hot that you couldn't, I couldn't enjoy the beach down there. We drove 6 hours for that, and I thought, you know, we spent about $250 a night on a condo. And we probably spent more time in the condo looking at the beach than we spent actually on the beach. But here in Guam, this is my style. Tropic Shade, baby. If I remember, before Typhoon Malwar, this whole little hillside here was covered with brush. Yes, we live on Gua. Aug. Been cleaned out. I kind of like it. Yeah, you can sit up here in the grass and look at the ocean now, in the shade, of course. There's nothing like tropic shade. Oh, and with some of that money I saved on all that dental work, well, we decided to give the barangay sign a facelift. An early Christmas present, and just in time for the upcoming village fiesta.